Hello all YouTubers, I am TheWeatherDude. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Thank you all for tuning in. Today's video is going to be about global warming and how it affects our weather. And I also have my updated forecast for the second half of December 2018, so please stay tuned for that. Let's get started on the weather presentation for today, December 17th, 2018. Just want to throw out a quick announcement. Don't tune out of this video just because it's like, because I'm going to be talking about Greenland for part of this video, so don't be like, oh, it's about Greenland, I'm never going to go there, I'm going to tune out. No, what happens in Greenland can affect our weather, so please stay tuned for that. So let's get started. So as always, please consider clicking the subscribe button, commenting, liking, and sharing my videos. Again, here are some videos you can watch on your own time if you enjoy watching videos like mine. So let's get right into it. So here are the oscillations. Let's start with the Arctic Oscillation. Of course, if you're on the East Coast, negative Arctic Oscillation, negative phase, means more cold and snow. And that is bad for Greenland. Unfortunately, a negative North Atlantic Oscillation is bad for Greenland, but good for us. Positive Arctic and positive North Atlantic Oscillations are good for Greenland, but bad for us if you're a snow lover. So here we are, Arctic oscillations, They have officially slipped into the negative phase. They're hovering right around zero, but they're slightly negative. Just slipped into negative, like negative 0.05, negative 0.1. And you can see the forecast, the ensemble forecast, as you go down around negative 2, come back up towards about 1, and then take a dip again as we head through New Year's. So that's something to watch there. Again, North Atlantic oscillations are back in the positives, which is bad if you're a snow lover that lives on the East Coast. So, watch as it's going to go down, according to the GEFS ensembles, and watch it goes down in about negative 0.75 and goes back into the positives as we head through New Year's. And notice these models, Arctic Oscillation, the models don't agree so much, but the North Atlantic Oscillations, they seem to be on a nice agreement. No, they're all pretty much in a nice, compacted together, it means it's a nice, they're agreeing nicely. So, our sea surface temperature anomalies, but if you look around Greenland, it's like a pro con. If you're a snow lover and you've always wanted to go to Greenland, or maybe you've been in Greenland, the sea surface temperature anomalies around the coast of Greenland are above average by about maybe 1 to 2. West side of Greenland, about 2 degrees above average, maybe about half degree or 1 degree above average on the east coast of Greenland. The pro is that this can fuel more snowstorms when they come up the coast. The con is that it can melt some of the sea ice that's off the coast. Now, granted, the temperatures are still cold off the coast of Greenland and at Greenland. They're still cold, but they're just, it's warmer than what they're used to. And again, the centrally specific sea surface temperatures are above average, as well as the Gulf of Alaska, which means El Nino, hopefully cold, snowy winter. Yay! So again, Arctic Oscillation is negative phase, cold for central and eastern United States, and you see the southerly flow because of a blocking high. So Greenland generally stays warmer, and also Western Europe is very cold during a negative phase of the Arctic Oscillation. Positive phase, with a weaker phase, it's a weaker wave year jet stream, so if the jet stream is weak, it's going to go up and down a lot. But for the positive phase, the jet stream is strong, and it's consistent, and it's just going to go straight across North America. So northern North America will be cold, and central and southern North America will be warm. But if you look at places like North Dakota, either oscillation, either negative or positive, you're basically cold. So it's like a win-win for you guys. So here's the North Atlantic Oscillation. So here's Greenland right here. Alright, so you have the high sitting right just off the coast of Greenland. Not only does it keep them warmer, but it's going to take all those storms and shove them into northern Greenland, and way up in the Arctic, way north of Greenland. That's what the high is going to do because it has that clockwise flow around it. And again, cold for Western Europe and cold for the Eastern United States. The low tracks down way down to the southeast. And then the high pulls it in way up into the Arctic, past the Hudson Bay, out of Greenland's reach. That's what the typical negative phase of the North Atlantic Oscillation. So let's jump right into the models here. GFS and Tropical Tidbits. Notice Greenland, they're still getting a lot of precipitation. If we look here, so here's Greenland up here on towards the top of your screen, and we watch one storm pass up, and then, but also watch the United States. It could be a nice stormy pattern for the next couple of weeks. We see another storm come offshore Alaska. We We have a low pressure here coming up through Michigan. And I did mention past couple of days possibility of a Christmas white snow that is starting to fade. Now, I have warned my snow lovers that things can change as quick as a model run, just a couple hours, a few hours. So that's why you shouldn't really get too excited before if you see a snow event like a week or so out. But watch this, day after New Year's Day, maybe you can add some snow along the I-95, New York to D.C. Again, am I guaranteeing it? No. This is like 15, almost 15 days from now. So, just a prediction, but I just want to throw it out there, it is possible. 2-meter temperature anomalies. The whole United States except Florida right now is basically above average temperatures. 2 meters, that's a little bit above our heads. It's a little bit in altitude, but it's very close to the surface. It's close you get to the surface temperatures. But if you watch Greenland, look how warm it is. Our temperatures are like 6 to 16 degrees above average in Greenland. I'll get to the actual temperatures in just a minute, but watch this. These storms, if they generally produce a lot of rain to the central and eastern United States, they're going to carry that warm air. Watch this storm right here. This storm's going to carry all that warm air with it, and watch this, boom. It just flows so nicely right into Greenland. And we're talking 20 degrees above average potentially. But northern Greenland's like 16 degrees below average. So it is a huge cutoff based on where you are. And once that warm shot leaves Greenland, we go under a cold shock here. Not really a shock for them, but it's going to go 20 degrees below average again. And then watch as the cold will potentially hold until in southern Canada near the Hudson Bay, another warm shot that could be potentially coming in the first week of January. That could potentially bring 30, 35 degrees above average. But again, that's a very long range forecast. I might have to make a video on that. Depends. So our 2 meter, these are our actual temperatures. And notice, even when we're above average, Greenland is still at like negative 10, negative 20. But once at your warmest, you're not too far off. You're like negative. Maybe barely even negatives, positives. But it depends. If towards the coast of Greenland, it's actually not too bad. 20s, I've even seen some 30s. I mean, it's not the coldest time of the year yet. But we have seen some 30s here. And watch this, negative 50s interior Greenland. But at the coast, we're in the teens. So interior Greenland is the coldest spot here. Look at this, negative 58. Watch these cold shots here. They try to make it in the U.S. these temperatures of 0 degrees or lower. They just can't quite get in there yet. But I assure you, once the high pressure and a negative North Atlantic Oscillation and negative Arctic Oscillation settle in, then we will have that potential for a lot more cold shots and a lot more snow to get in. This is a new website I discovered. I don't know how it's pronounced. Ventusky, I think it's how it's pronounced. So you see the winds coming out of the northwest, but like what I'd like to use is the freezing level. So it's basically saying how far up in elevation do you have to go to find temperatures 32 degrees or lower. And right now, this was updated about 45 minutes ago. If we look at 8 o'clock, so it's basically 15 minutes from now. North Delaware only have to go 2,000 feet up to find 32 degree temperatures. Philadelphia only have to go 2,000 feet up. Same thing for Baltimore. As you go down towards D.C., you have to go up a little bit higher, maybe 2,600 feet because of the warm temperatures down there. But once you work in the Virginia, like around Charlottesville, almost 10,000 feet, Charlottesville, Harrisburg, just to find 32 degree temperatures or lower. So as we track this through, we go to 10 o'clock. As temperatures get colder, the freezing level is going to start to fall to near surface as we go through overnight. So precipitation, it has been, oh my goodness, a lot. Past 180 days, year to date has been 60, 70 inches of snow. I mean, rain, excuse me, precipitation. So it's been a very wet year so far. And totals, in fact, from North Carolina, particularly due to Florence, are almost 100 inches of rain plus. So that is all for today's video. I hope you learned a lot about global warming and my December forecast. I am the Weather Dude, signing off. Till next time.